مرحبا.
Hello. Welcome to our third part of connecting Arabic letters with me, Nada. So today we are going to continue how we are going to connect the Arabic letters. Now, last time we stopped at the letter Ayn or Ghayn. And as you know, that letters who look like each other, they have the same connection rules. Today, we are going to continue how we can connect Arabic letters. Starting with the letter Tha, and of course, the same connection rules apply to the letter Qaf. Fa and Qaf, they have the same connection rules. So, the first word we are going to start with where Fa or Qaf are in the beginning is Fa. Taha. Open, fataha, fataha. So as you can see, that's the shape of it in the beginning. It gets connected with the letter after it. Now, in the middle, ya, yaf, tahu, yaftahu. Remember the letter Ayn or Ghayn, when they were in the middle, we used to write them as a triangle. Remember this? Yeah. So why do we do it this way? Just to know which one is Ayn, Ghayn, and which one is Fa, Qaf. So Fa or Qaf, it's like a circle and a dot above it. Okay? Fa, that is in the middle. Fa or Qaf, like this. Okay? Circles. But Ayn or Ghayn, they are triangles. Just to know the difference between them. Okay? Continuing. So this is Yaftahu in the middle. Then we have A, Ra, Fa. Of course, the end part is divided into two parts, like the last time. If the letter before it gets connected with the one after it or not. Now, we know that the letter Ra, let me make it clear that this is Ra. A, Ra, Fa. Ra, we know from the last time that it doesn't get connected with the letter after it. So, Fa will stand alone. And, Shawk. I'm sorry, not chalk. Atafa, sorry. Okay, a ta fa. Now the ta gets connected with the one after it. So the fa will get connected with it. Atafa. Okay, now this applies for fa or qaf. So if this was qaf, no problem. Okay? Going for the letter Kaf in the beginning. Now, the letter Kaf in the beginning and the middle, how do we draw it? It doesn't stay as it is. We draw it like this. Ka, and gets connected with the one after it. Kamil. Kamil. Can you see how it is? How the shape of it changed from this to like an inclined line, and then another inclined line, and a straight line. It's like a Z, but the Z is like that, right? Now, it's not really a Z, but this line is a little bit inclined. Okay, so this is how we draw the calf in the beginning. Okay, in the middle, it's the same, but gets connected with the one before it. Then we draw our calf, and then the one after it. Okay? Now, in the end, two parts. Yashukku and Shauk. Now, Shauk. Wow, wow, I told you last time, it doesn't get connected with the letter after it, so the calf will stand alone. But if we have Yashukku, the Sha gets connected with the one after it. So we will connect it and draw it as it is. So in the end, it stays the same shape, either if it's connected or not. But in the middle and in the beginning, we just change its shape. We draw it like similar to the letter Z, okay? Now, Lam. Now, the beginning part of Lam, I will divide it. Let us take the general shape of it in the beginning. Now, the shape is the same. I just wanted to point out something. So, Lama. Lama, this is in the beginning. Now, sometimes after the lam comes alif. So if there's an alif after the lam, we draw the lam, and then the alif comes this way. Lama. And then we draw the other letters. But here we don't connect the lam. Remember here, if there's an alif after the lam, we draw the lam and attach to it the alif this way, and then the other letters, they don't get connected with the lam, because actually after it there's an alif, and the alif doesn't get connected with the one after it. Okay, but when there is a lam before the alif, that's how we connect it. And actually this word lam and alif connected to it is la. La, and this means no in Arabic, okay? No, okay? So I have to memorize it. No is la, okay? Okay, so one new vocabulary for today. Maybe you knew it before, but it's good to learn it. So, lama, okay? Shining, lama, shining, okay. Now, ya l a bu yalabu. Now this is lam in the beginning. In the end, two parts. Mal, if before there's an alif, it doesn't get connected with it. Okay? But if the alif is after it, of course it gets connected with it, because the lam, it gets connected with the one before it and after it, except if the one before it doesn't get connected with it. But the alif, if it's before the lam, it gets connected with it, because the lam gets connected with the one after it. So it always it depends on the letter before it, okay? Ma l lal malal. Now before the lam there's another lam. Malal. There is another lam before this lam, okay? But I just wanted to show you that whatever, if this letter gets connected with the one after it, if it's a lam, sheen, ta, whatever, it gets connected with it and it stays as it is. Going for meme. Mauj. 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 The meme is always down, so that we don't mix it with the fa and the qa. So, if it's in the middle, for example, qa, mar, qamar, moon, قمر. Now, the meme. In the middle, it's different. You know the fa and the qaf, they're a circle but up. The meme is a circle which is down. Okay? So that we don't mix them together. Okay? قمر. Now, the end part. نام. He slept. نام. Okay? نام. Sleep. نام. Now, هم. If there's a ha before it, the ha gets connected with the one after it. Now, sometimes in the end, if you can see, sometimes in the end, the meme, the letter meme, is a circle up and sometimes it's a circle down. Only in the end or in the beginning. For example, موج. Sometimes in the beginning, I don't know if you can see it or not, but in the middle, because you know, I will tell you now the difference. Look at the fa in the beginning. Now, if I'm drawing a ma, the ma will be like this, even if it's a circle and up, but there's a difference. The fa is like a circle and then a straight line, but the ma, okay, circle, I'm just showing you the difference, circle and the straight line, but the ma, even if it's up, okay, it's like this, like, okay, let me draw it as a circle. It's like a circle attached immediately to the straight line, but here it has like a vertical line and then a horizontal line. This is the fa, while this is the ma in the beginning. In the middle, we said we always have to draw the ma down just to distinguish them between each other. In the end, it can be like this or this, but of course I'm not going to mix them because you can see it clearly, it's a ma. Okay, because there is this line, you can see it a ma, even if the circle is above or below. But in the middle, you have to do it below, just to distinguish them. In the beginning, I think it's clear if the circle is down or up, you know it's a ma and different from the fa. Okay? Now, going to the other letters, I will erase the board and then write the next four letters. Okay? So, continuing our lesson, now, noon, the letter noon. The letter noon in the beginning. For example, let me take the word Nimr. 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 Okay? Tiger. Nimr. Now, in the middle, ma, na, a, mana. Yeah, the end part. Mana. And we have after mana two things. Hana. If before it there's an alif, it stands alone. And musin. Before it asa gets connected with it. Okay. Ha. Hawa. Hawa. In the middle, ha. Mahr. Now, the ha in the middle, look how I'm going to draw it. Did you see how I did it? Two circles above each other. Mahr. Okay, I'll draw it again. connected with the one before it. Circle up, circle down. We go again on the straight line. Okay? This is the letter Ha and how we draw it. Okay? Now, in the end, before it an alif, sha. In the end, the ha stands as a circle. So it stands as a circle. Okay? Because actually that's the origin of the letter. Okay? Only in the middle it's this shape, like this. Circle and another circle. Okay? You have to practice on drawing the letters. Now, in the end, but before there's a letter that gets connected to the one after it, let me make this line like this because it's a little bit long. In ta beh, it stands like this in the end, connected with the one before it. In ta beh. Intabih, intabih, okay? Now, wow, the letter wow, wa, fa, wafa. Of course, it doesn't get connected with the one after it, like I told you before. In the middle, noor. Light, noor. In the end, amru, amru, amru. Now, most of the people, they spell it as amr, but I'm just showing you how to write it. Okay, it doesn't get connected with the one before it. And if before it another letter like lam gets connected with it. Dallu. Going for the letter ya. Ya in the beginning. Ya. Yasir. Yasir. Now in the middle we have ha. Ya. And anun. Now, in the end, ma-ri. Now, before there's a ra, so it stands alone, but if before it there is the letter da, it gets connected with it and stands alone. Let me draw it a little bit clear. There's a ba, and it gets connected with it, and the two dots. Radi. So, these were the letters, all the letters. We finished them, finished how to connect them, how to spell them. Now I'm going to give you a homework. So, now what is homework in Arabic? Okay, I'm just erasing and the board is not stable. Okay, yeah. So, yeah, now the homework. Can you see the board? Yeah, okay. What is homework in Arabic? Homework in Arabic. Wajib. Wajib. What is it? Wajib. Okay. This is a jim. Okay. This is a jim if you can't understand it. Wajib. I want you to connect these letters. Actually, it's a sentence. You will know the meaning of it in the next lesson. I just want you to connect the words. The first word of the sentence is made up of these three letters. ألف كاف لام. Connect these to form a word. So this is the first word of our sentence. I want you to connect these letters to form a word. And then the second word is connect these to form another word, second word of our sentence. Okay, I don't know if you can see, so I'm going to write it more clearly. Okay, like this. Okay. Okay. Alif, Kaf, Lam, and this is Alif but without a Hamza. Lam, Waw, La, Lam, and Da. And then Alif, Lam, Ta, Ain, Alif, Mim. Okay. Now, this is the first word of our sentence. Second word, third word. So this forms a sentence. Those are the words that form our sentence. In the next lesson, I will show you how to connect the letters to form the words. And I will show you how they form a sentence. What does the sentence mean? Everything in the next lesson. And we will continue also knowing what is at-tashkil. At-tashkil, or the Arabic vowels, we will see them or know them in our next lesson. Please don't forget to study well and to like my video, subscribe to my channel to see our next videos. And I am going to tell you now, ila al-liqa, see you.